Shout outs. Oh, snap. It's that bar. What up, heads? Start Friday. It's Friday. Let's drink. Okay. Shout out! It's that Redbar radio show. Welcome to Friday, everybody. The best day of the week. Shout out. Here we are. I'll probably break it to you, right at the beginning here. Slow week over in the bar universe, okay? So a lot of people, what they do on their shows is when, they can't really find any of the ultra-exciting stuff to talk about, they kind of start filling in the blanks with nonsense, okay? So you see that a lot of shows, they have all these topics they don't really care about, but they fill time. And so usually what I like to do is throughout the week, I like to, make a little note of something that I'm really behind, something that I really could have some fun with. And I only got like four of those today. Shout outs. So we'll see what happens. But you know how this show goes. We never get to anything anyway. And half the time you guys fill in the blanks with links. You know what I have been getting? People message me. I'm iffy on covering this because he's such a nice guy. I don't want to offend him. Joe Matrice. Do we know this guy? He's co-hosted Kumi a couple times. I have no problem with him. Again, a lot of times I'm going to bring up men. I don't necessarily have a problem with these men. But they might do some stunts here, some errors that maybe we have to watch over here on the screen. So people have been sending me this Joe Matrice video, and I never got to it. And they're like, you got to see this thing. This guy is bombing left and right. It gets so awkward. You got to see this whole thing from the front to the beginning. And apparently, this guy, he was a comedian. He's been on the Kumia show a bunch of times. He's got like a gray beard and gray hair. And he's like, Anthony, it's so great to be here. Yeah. I went downtown today, had three sips of coffee, almost slipped on a banana peel. But he's younger. I mean, he's not like that impression might make it sound like he's an older man, but he's kind of young. And he did this live show at the Comedy Cellar with Artie Lang. Hey, I stabbed myself in the stomach. Look me in the eye. Anthony Cumia, all hail the king. And Jim Norton. It was a great guy. I like him now. Again, I was a little iffy with Jim about his sobriety. I don't like people that are sobriety guys in their mid-40s because they thought they had a problem when they were 16 drinking. They haven't really given it another shot. I would say conquer that. Death needs to be covered, Mike, but with respect since since it's the king's friend. Yeah. So this Joe Matrice guy, he did this live show. I haven't watched this. And apparently, there's a lot of bombaroos. And I didn't even pay attention to it until today. Somebody tweeted it to me, the video again. And I go, okay, finally, there's been a dozen people. Let's check it out. And I go to click it. And it says, this video is private. So this Joe Matrice has taken down the video, which makes me go, ooh, the forbidden fruit. Now this could be good. He says, not my favorite guest. Dude seems always sleepy. Really? I think he seems awake. I think a very nice guy. But that doesn't mean it can't be very, very funny to watch a very nice guy have a couple meltdowns. Some of the best stuff. I love public bomberoos, people bombing. Norton called him out for being resentful of their jokes. Woo! So he took down the video, which makes me want to watch it even more. But don't worry. This had to be good enough because he took down the video today. But somebody knew this must, this is too good to be true. They made a backup. And they emailed me the backup. Shout out. So we have that, and maybe we'll check it out during the after show, but I want to preface this. This is in with respects to the king. You know, because it gets around. They don't watch the show, and then they just hear, oh, do you see this? He's going after all your co-hosts. He's saying they suck. No. I haven't said nothing yet. The people are saying this. I'm just doing the fool's reporting. Hold on. Open that up a little bit. Close it up. Last week, it was a little funky for my ears. Well, welcome to Redbar. I do have a very exciting private message from somebody you all know and love, one of our biggest fools of the season, who will definitely win a fool's award this year, messaged me. And you're not going to believe what the message says. So that will be coming up. And then we've got a ton of Proud Boys stuff. But I want to go about this Proud Boys thing a little bit differently than usual today. Because I had a couple Proud Boys reach out to me about some stuff that I didn't consider. So we might be giving the Proud Boys a third chance today on the show. All right, let's see what the chat's saying. You could join us at redbarradio.net/chat. I've listened to his podcast. It's very inconsistent. Sometimes he's really funny, and sometimes he's depressingly cringe. They're talking about this Joe Matrice guy. He has a lot of emotional problems. Oh, dear. Yeah, I had never heard of him until he came on Kumia, and he seems like a nice guy, but I really want to see what happens in this. This is so mean, says someone. Uh-oh. I feel Matrice is Kumia's go-to fill-in guest when somebody bigger doesn't show. So this is what we're talking about on the show. People like to always blame me. They go, Mike's jealous of these guys. You know, he likes to just attack these people. It's always brought to me. It's always this group thing. I'm not trying to push blame away from myself when I get in trouble here, but it's always this collective build of resentment or, holy shit, did you see what this guy did? You know, that's what Mealman doesn't want you to know. Mealman thinks that this is something personal with me. And these fools don't seem to realize that. No. We don't have a problem with you until the errors add up. So what happens is you start with a guy. Okay, you take a guy. Blank slate. You don't know anything about him except for the looks. So looks aside, you take a guy and you go, let's give him the benefit of the doubt. Okay. Seems like a decent man. And then years go by, and if they are making these errors and these slip-ups, you go, that little slip-up didn't mean anything. You know, a good point to that. They like to, and then I'll finish that thought. They like to always pinpoint one of the easiest things. So a fool will always go, they're calling me the lobster. That's all they got? You know, this is so dumb. I'm a lobster? No, it's one of the thousand things. And, if it was just that lobster freestyle that Tony did, we wouldn't be covering it. So the fools don't seem to understand. It's a million small things that add up to, okay, we got a fool. We got a guy here. He's nuts. Take a look. Let's laugh. Let's have fun. So, yeah, when the fools fight back, they like to always pick out just one of the thousand small things. And, yes, alone, on paper, that little tiny thing.
They make fun of me for eating wings.
Yeah, it's one of the many things. And because we don't like you so much, because you're such a fool, the wings is funny. If I eat wings, if I eat 50 wings, nobody's talking about it. Now, if I eat chicken fingers, that's another story. People will be talking about that for ages. But that's kind of how it works. And the other thing I wanted to mention with covering fools is this is a comedy show, whether you want to believe that or not. Okay, that's what we consider ourselves to be. And we're doing this because it's fun. We're not doing this because we're trying to stop you or we're out to get you. You know, the number one reason is because watching you make blunders is awfully exciting. And, you know, as far as shows go, what would you rather do? Watch a man make blunders, laugh, reveal, or sit there and just go, so how'd you get into comedy? This is wonderful. Oh, really? What do you do to prepare to get on? Who gives a shit? So I got to keep stressing that because I think some of our fools, they don't seem to understand the concept. You've got some fools going, they haven't done shit. They've been making fun of me for a year and they haven't done shit. Yeah, we're not trying to do shit besides make fun of you. So as long as we had the laughs, we accomplished our goal. I always hear with people, what's the end goal here with the Proud Boys? There's no end goal. We're laughing at mistakes. So I really want to make that clear. It's not about taking people down. It's not about ending them. Those happen to be things that happen sometimes. Sometimes these people we go after, they do crumble. Sometimes we do take credit for the crumblings, but that's not the goal. So I want to set that straight. The only thing we're interested in doing here is making fun of you, and anything we do happens right here using my real name. You see my face, you see me do it. There's no behind-the-scenes sneakery. There is no reporting. You know, not a week goes by where the Proud Boys don't accuse me of reporting them to their jobs or reporting their Facebook posts. I have zero interest in that. I need my fools up, active, and working. I can't have them away. You know, what would I cover? If you're not on Facebook, if you get fired from your, well, the fired from your job would be funny, but I wouldn't do that, okay? Never have, never will. So I need to be taken off the suspect list. I know you want to blame me because, oh, look, you know, Mike makes fun of this guy every week. Must be him. It ain't me. You got worse enemies, apparently. Okay? Also, don't have such a shitty job. Don't have everything so delicate that it could all be taken away just like that. Mike's show is intense correctional behavior therapy for internet celebs, LOL, someone says. Okay, that's very nice. It's a very thoughtful way to look at it. But I need to make this perfectly clear over and over again and spread the word. Tell your friends. We never report. We never do any sneaky stuff behind the scenes unless it's a big practical joke. Okay? You know, for instance, I came up with this practical joke. Which practical jokes should be, even if they're illegal, they should be waived because they're so practical. I have this idea. Tony Hinchcliffe is coming to Chicago to do some big shows. And I had this idea that we call the venue. We pretend to be his manager or agent or booking person, whatever. We call the venue, the comedy club or whatever. And we say, hey, listen, Tony is filming something for this sketch series that he's doing. We want to do this thing where we have everybody in the audience wearing lobster bibs. And when he comes up to the stage, he's going to be like, oh my God. And it's all for film. So we want to set this up. We'll send over the bibs to you. And I guess you could just hand them out as people are seated or however you want to do it. You know, just disposable bibs. And that'd be great. Any venue that he's playing at will agree to do that. They won't question it. They'll go, okay, yeah, it seems like it's... Now, yeah, there could be a time where they go, I don't know about this. I'm going to call his real booking agent to see. But most of the time, you're talking to an underling. They're not going to have any doubts. You know, they've had crazier requests, and we could have that happen. That is a sneaky practical joke. That's about as far as we go. We're sneakery. Okay? We really need to be clear with that because we're getting blamed left and right. You know, Gavin emailed me. Did we cover this stuff? You know, I always get confused on what happened like Saturday, Sunday, Monday because it is far away. Gavin emailed me. You calling this guy's work and trying to get him fired? No, Gavin. You ask me things like this every week. The answer is always going to be no. And Proud Boys left and right posting, these Redbar fags are getting... We're not the guys doing that. We're the guys that make fun of you publicly using our real names. We're not having private chats about you. You know, as far as having Proud Boy spies in our Facebook group, you're welcome. It's a comedy show. So, yeah, we don't have a secret group like the Proud Boys where we're concocting evil plans. So we don't care if our gags and making fun of you is screenshotted. We really got to get over this. You're being made fun of. That's it. Somebody says, holy hell, that's genius. I hope you're talking about the lobster bib thing. Yeah, maybe we could still do that. We could even discuss that openly and probably still get that prank to work. Pranks are hard to set up, but the payoff could be good. I want to show you this. We got a lot of Proud Boys stuff today, and I want to clear the air with the Proud Boys. And I actually have another deal that I'd like to make with the Proud Boys, because they have been desperately reaching out to me this week. They don't like being made fun of. Okay, they got enough problems of their own. Their whole empire is crumbling beneath them this week. I guess, really, you know, whatever we showed you last week about the Proud Boys, it's doubled. Okay? my birthday is tomorrow, everybody. My birthday is tomorrow. Keep that in mind, okay? I'd like to see my Facebook feed covered in well wishes, you know, and be original. Not just happy B-Day, Mike. Because, you know what? It's, you know, not that big a deal. We're talking about, well, we'll get into that later. I want to show you this video. Do you guys remember Mac Lethal? This will be a good video to drink some wine to and get into the mood for our big Friday day today. Okay? Mac Lethal, he used to be like, you know, he's an underground rapper. You might know him from some of his fast raps on YouTube. He became really, really big on YouTube. You know, like millions of subscribers after he started doing this really fast rap stuff. He's a white guy. He's short. He's from Kansas City. And he used to actually put out, like, you know, rap songs. And then he did Ellen. He started doing these fast raps, which were very good, very talented. Then he did Ellen. We made fun of that. Remember, he went on Ellen and he made a rap for her about how great she was. To me, once you're rapping about Ellen, you ain't no rapper anymore. Okay? His latest video, I got to show you this. It just might be the most sickening thing I've ever seen. It's called Rapping a Verse Forward and Backward. Let's watch this, and we'll open the wine and get this bash started, okay? Shout-outs to the heads. Here we go, Mac Lethal. Listen to his beats. His beats so fucking whack lately. Woo! He's balding.
I guess I better vent. Holy effing shit. Donald Trump is America's president.
Donald Trump.
I'm happy, okay? And now you can't say minorities feel comfortable in the USA.
Wow.
I just hope the cops kill black people every day. And I hate shit. We gotta give women equal pay. Not. I'm so racist, a lot of white people are. You'll get shot, you're gay, just because it's evil. Not CBS, watch Fox News. It's racist people, fuck welfare. Say let's go Maine. Looks like President Trump is slow pain. Bring it, women grab Trump. You miss his universe, eh? Bomb, oh thanks, the Russia with best friends. Fuck your daughter, immigrants need to be deported from America.
Oh,
what kind
God.
Of idiot believes we don't need to build a big wall? It makes me sick, y'all.
Have you ever heard anything so cringe? I mean, this guy really, I wish I had something to compare it to. He used to be something someone took serious. And now it's this. There's something so weird with the Trump hate. It almost takes over these people's body. You know, this is what I've been focused on since the beginning. It's the lack of creativity. It seems to be. When an entertainer hates Trump and latches onto this weird thing that we've been seeing all year, which I need more, by the way, I need it to be discussed more. And not just, oh, liberal tears and all this. What has driven entertainers to drop everything they're doing and become 24-hour, 7-day-a-week Trump reporters and investigators and arguers? Not only that, it seems to have stripped them of any self-awareness of, you know, the fact that they have to be original, you know, the fact that they shouldn't be hack, they shouldn't repeat jokes. I mean, here you go. Here's Mac Lethal. You know, you see Sarah Silverman every day. These people used to be original. They used to have something to say. It's like that's been gutted from their souls. That, to me, has been the weirdest part. you know, the repeating, you know, how many times did you see an entertainer? I just saw on the cover of GQ, The Weeknd has an interview, you know, The Weeknd, Weeky. He's got an interview in GQ, and the big quote that they pulled on the cover or to advertise this was, how do you even grab somebody by the pussy? The fact that that line was muttered so many times this year by people who were supposed to be creatives, it just really makes me curious as to what happened. It's like an invasion of the brain snatchers type situation. All right, shout outs, we're drinking wine. There's a second part to this, which I'll play for you right now. Look at this.
Now let's reverse that, Red.
All right.
And see if we can find a different or better meaning.
This sounds awesome.
It makes me sick, y'all. We don't need to build a big wall. What kind of idiot believes immigrants need to be deported from America? A daughter fucker, best friends with Russia. Thanks, Obama. Universe misses you. Trump grabs women, bringing pain slow.
Trump grabs
President
women.
President Trump looks like a mango. Let's say farewell. Fuck racist people.
President Trump looks like a mango. You know, first of all, you guys are supposed to be anti-bullying and making fun of people. How does he look like a mango? It's not a dope line. Somebody says, I don't mind when Bill Burr criticizes Trump because he's original and it's not coming from a place of insanity. Exactly. Mike, your sound effects add nothing to the show. Mind your own business. I'm pretty scared by all this censored entertainers. Better get it together fast. Yeah, it's very, very weird. I don't know if you've been watching, but I think TV and movies have gotten terrible. I watched the Golden Globes. I couldn't stomach it. We really turned it off after 20 minutes. I had never felt so much anger. You know, I had heard about my dad. I'd heard stories about this kind of anger when watching award shows from my dad. I'd never understood it. He'd be so mad when we were a kid and my mom would put on an award show. Oh, he'd get so negative and pissed. And I finally really felt that feeling while watching the Golden Globes. I don't hate everybody in entertainment, but I really hate actors right now more than anybody. For some reason, I can't look at them as anything but scum-sucking, lying, phony, twisted, despicable men and women in that Golden Globes. Was really, really, really tough to watch. Like I said, I got out of there really fast. And the same thing with movies. Go to iTunes. I go to iTunes every week because I like how they have the big movie covers. I just get to see what came out on Blu-ray. And you look and you go, who are these movies? I don't need to see Ben Affleck being like an assassin. Every movie that they've got there has got like a 5.0 on IMDb. If you're lucky, it's up to a 6. There are these dreary, depressing girl on a train. Or then you got these horrible thrillers. The other thing that I noticed, too, here, I'll show you this. There's really something going on. It's different than ever before. Let's go to this iTunes store right now, and I'll show you. Hopefully you can see this here. Okay. Here we go. Here are the movie covers. You're not going to be able to see them that good, I guess. Let's talk about the movie covers. They haven't advanced since 2004. Okay? They've been the same cheesy-looking cover. I mean, there's really no imagination going into these movies. The covers, the trailers are identical. It's like they stopped progressing. They stop being creative. They stop coming up with new concepts. You know, you look at the cover. Look at the cover of Snowden. Look at the cover. Sully. Jason Bourne. Max Steele. What now? Deepwater Horizon. This is what I'm talking. These are the movies we have to choose from. Deepwater Horizon. Look at this font. Who is this? Matt Damon? How dare they give this movie an 83? What's it about? Some guy struggles? Do they have a scene where he talks to his wife on an iPad? It really, to me, It's despicably bad what they're giving it. Denial. Look at this. Look at these courtroom dramas and all the accountant. Here we go. This is the one. Here's Ben Affleck holding a gun. I don't need it. He's been in enough movies. You know, in 1950, maybe the star system worked where you would get a popular actor and just put him in movie after movie. I really don't think it works anymore. I think we have content at our fingertips now. We have stimulation anytime we want. I think these movies are outdated. I don't think they're doing us any service anymore. And I don't think we need to see Ben Affleck in four movies a year. It doesn't seem to be working. 51%. And then they're going to have an award ceremony, like the Deplorable, where they all get dressed up and give each other awards for their 51% Rotten Tomatoes nonsense movies. Paint by numbers, same old nonsense that we've seen over and over again. And then they're going to get up there and tell us how to live life while they make millions of dollars with the same old scheme that kind of needs to wrap it up. It's really starting to anger me. And you know what? The other thing I noticed at the Golden Globes, this woman from American Horror Story, you know, she was in the O.J. Simpson. She played the state attorney, Marsha Clark Duncan. Who's the woman, the two-headed woman? She's in every American Horror Story on FX. This bitch has really schemed her way to the top. I'll tell you why. So American Horror Story gets nominated every year at the Golden Globes or the Emmys because it's in the, what do they call it? The limited series category, the short miniseries category. So, yeah, they have this miniseries category at the award shows for TV, and it's usually all shit, you know. How good could it be? Miniseries is, imagine. So they give it to American Horror Story every year, and this woman keeps winning, and American Horror Story keeps winning. This is not an Emmy award-worthy show. This is not any award-worthy show. Sure, the show doesn't entirely stink, but this is not a show that we should be applauding. This woman from American Horror Story has the nerve to show up to the Emmys in a gown and go up on stage as if she's put in a lot of hard work. You've been in a horror story, bitch. This ain't even that good. It's just that loophole, that miniseries loophole. But because of that loophole, she's tricked everybody into thinking that she's a serious actress, an award-winning actress. Because they see her every year get awards, and these people, you know. So imagine like all the other people in Hollywood, you know, they probably don't watch American Horror Story. They're too busy thinking about themselves. But they see her winning every year. So they assume she's one of them, that she's some accomplished actress who's really good. And now they're treating her like that. It's the biggest scheme I've ever seen. And then they have this O.J. Simpson show that got all the awards at the Golden Globes, and I'm sitting there going, okay, we need to put a stop to this. Is there anything more tacky? I don't care if these performances in this show about O.J. Simpson made you weep. I don't care if they were life-changing. There's nothing tackier than an O.J. Simpson documentary show or whatever they call it. They're reenacting the O.J. Simpson trial. Can you think of anything lamer or more tacky? It shouldn't be given awards. I can't go, oh, the OJ. All these people are still alive, by the way. Everybody, except for the two, you know, that got hacked to death. Those people are all still alive. Maybe they don't want to watch you dress up like them and play the OJ story. It's a little too soon. John Travolta's involved. Nicole Kidman. These people have gone on far enough. To me, I'm sickened. I'm completely sickened by their antics. I really can't do it anymore. You turn on these movies, they're bummers. Let's have some fun, Deepwater Horizon. Look at your font. You think that's cool? You think that looks like Chrome? Look at this. Kevin Hart stars in What Now using the same font. A Chrome font. or this metal, brushed metal. You think that looks good in those 3D letters? Update. It's 2005 in Hollywood. So yeah, what's going on? What's happened? Why have they fallen so far behind? Or are we just getting so much better? Shout out to Mike's knee hole. Yes, shout outs. Roseanne, let's read the chat. Travolta, LOL. I was on board until the 15th storyline brought in aliens or whatever. Yeah, they're talking about American Horror Story. Travolta was horrible in that OJ show. Yeah, he's a sick man. He's wearing a toupee. They've parted it in the middle. You know, I just don't understand how much longer this can go on. And I think we need to deactivate our friends and family from thinking these people mean something. They used to mean something, you know, before the internet, before before entertainment was pouring out of every fucking crack. Movies meant something. You couldn't get it anywhere else. You went to the movies, you went to TV, you couldn't get your entertainment anywhere else. But now that we're getting it other places, it just seems so stupid, so silly. I can't wait for the Boston bombing movie, they're saying. Exactly. Yeah, just stop. Mike, they did studies in 2001. Ratings for movies, TV, and video went down, bro. Cool. Cool. All right, let's hear Mac Lethal finish this up. Again, another guy who used to be creative, and all of a sudden, this Trump thing infected his mind, and now he's got this.
Slow. President Trump looks like a mango. Let's say farewell, fuck racist people. Watch Fox News, it's not CBS, it's evil. Just because you're gay, you'll get shot. A lot of white people are racist, so I'm not. We gotta give women
a lot of white people are racist, so I'm not. Pretty cool line. Nice headphones. Nice balding.
We'll pay. And I hate that cops kill black people every day.
That cops kill black people every day. It's like, they don't listen to any of the arguments for these things. They like go further and further with the make-believe lines.
Minorities feel comfortable in the USA. Now you can't say I'm happy, okay? Donald Trump is America's president. Holy effing shit, I guess I better vent.
Holy fuck, huh? Subscribe to my channel. Pretty cool. Pretty fucking cool. That's your Mac Lethal update for the day. It's getting chilling out there. What was the other thing? Oh, yeah, he had his press conference. People were mad about that. Patton Oswalt. Rosie O'Donnell saying that she wants martial law instated for some fucking cockamamie reason. It's really, somebody needs to step in. It's gone too far. One of my favorite crybabies,
Kumail Nanjiani, part of the Nanjiani myth from Pakistan.
Kumail Nanjiani, he doesn't stop. He still talks about crying. But then somebody posted this in the Bringback group, and I think this is incredible. You guys know Funko and their pop vinyl toys? Surely you've heard of these. These things make me sick, by the way.
I got in an argument with the people from Pop, from Funko, on Twitter once.
These Pop Vitals, you've seen these. These are these bobblehead dolls. But they have this really infantile baby look to them. But you know who buys them? Adult men. Adult men by the thousands. I bet you go into Mike Lawrence's house. God bless him. I like Mike Lawrence. But I bet you go into his house and he's got a Pop Vinyl. Hell, I have a Pop Vinyl. But it's of Red Skull. Pop vinyls are baby toys. They're literally, you know,
what do they say? What are the age ranges on here?
I would say this is for ages 1 month and up. They're the gayest looking bobbleheads that I've ever seen. They've completely taken the whole caricature
out of the face. It's just this big alien head.
And it's made out of this soft rubber. It's not detailed at all. But they come out with thousands of them. You know, for everything that gets popular in nerd culture and beyond, they come out with a Pop Vinyl. I don't know how the factory does it. I really don't know how the factory does it. I would love a documentary of this Pop Vinyl factory and how they're pumping out
all of these likenesses.
You know, millions.
But here it is, everybody. They've decided that they're going to do Pop Vinyls of Silicon Valley characters. The show Kumail Nanjiani is in. And look at this. Here he is, everybody. Dinesh. Dinesh. That's what they had the nerve to name this fucking guy on Silicon Valley. There he is. Kumail Nanjiani, official Funko Pop vinyl doll. Number 433, Dinesh. This must be purchased for our Fool's Museum. Imagine. You know, I never liked pop vinyls. In fact, I put out a tweet a while ago saying, if you collect pop vinyls, you know, your father might be gay. Something like that. And Pop Vinyl got very mad and started, you know, arguing with me about it on Twitter. I couldn't believe my eyes. But here it is. Buy Funko.
The Kumail Nanjiani Pop Vinyl.
We need it. We need it right here in the studio to bring them up for every time we cover Kumail. Perfect addition to the Fool's Museum. Love this. I still haven't gotten any word on getting me one of those Lady Alchemy shirts. You know, before they're fucking gone from her store, I need that Lady Alchemy shirt. It's shop.myshopify-lady-alchemy.html or something like that. I need that white shirt with the thing. That would be a great birthday gift. Dinesh would be a great birthday gift. We should start calling him Dinesh. What do you like better, Kumail or Dinesh? Ugh. So, there it is. Lady Alchemy, by the way. Woo! Man, I don't even know where to start with some of this Lady Alchemy stuff this week. First of all, we did an excellent show the other day. Remember Sven Stuffles? He started this new show called Sven Streams. It's his, you know, he's an artist, he's an animator, and what he does is he sits down and he starts drawing. There's listener interaction, it's a live show, there's a chat and such. Here, I'll pull it up, Sven Streams. And he had Jack Buckby on as a guest. Let's see this, Sven Stuffles. And you guys should watch these. I don't know why people aren't watching these. I think they think they're just going to be lame. But watch episode 3. I think that you're really going to start falling in love with Sven Streams. I'm going to show you a preview real quick here. So he had Jack Buckby on his show. This is the latest Sven Streams. You can find it on YouTube. And because he had Buckby on, he started drawing Lady Alchemy. And I'll just give you a preview of some of this right now so you can see Lady Alchemy. And some of the work that he does to her live on the stream. And this is just a random part. I don't know what's going to be talked about here, but here we go. There's a little preview. And I think this will bring us into some Lady Alchemy coverage. America's favorite, Foulette.
Oh, sorry.
Ah, you.
Oh, shit.
Not because of any other reason, except I think it's degrading towards women.
So here's Alchemy here.
But I thought, isn't the burqa the thing that you thought was degrading towards women? Did you want women to be free?
I don't.
Are you? When, you prefer a woman to have bird paws? Kind of like a chicken leg?
Like, if you pulled down my trousers, you'd find I'm wearing women's panties.
Jack Buckley.
Of course, yes. From mom.
I've noticed you also wear high heels as well, Buckley.
Yes. I mean, so how can you tell? They're inside the shoe.
Oh, shit.
Okay, so this is kind of
your
a bad,
whole shoe is like a
kind of a bad part to start playing here. Okay, let's zoom in. Here's Alchemy. You can see your body. You can see them varicose veins. Yeah, people in the chat. Sven's show is awesome. It really is a good show. For real, it's not one of these shows that's hard to get into at all. You put it on in the background. You know what? It's a great morning show to listen to. You're getting up. You're preparing your coffee. You're sitting there. The world is calm. It's a nice, calm, relaxing show to watch. Sven Streams. Let's blow this thing up. Sven Stuffles on YouTube.
I like that.
That's here's Alchemy.
Do you understand the double meaning now?
I do understand the double meaning.
You understand? It's a hot topic out there.
Satire. That is very...
In Martina's case, a cold topic. That's in the joke book.
That's a good one.
61! They're not numbered, though.
So here it is. Yeah, not much to see, especially if you're listening to the audio version. Kind of hard to show you. But Sven Streams, I would say check out episode 3. If you love Lady Alchemy and Buckby stuff, you're going to love this episode. 2 hours long, a perfect mid-morning show for you guys to watch. So I'm bringing up Alchemy. You know, right now, we've got somebody in the chat, Lady Alchemy Snatch. People are really into this Lady Alchemy stuff. And so today's going to be a little weird. And for the Prouds listening, for Jack Buckby listening, and for Alchemy listening, I have a deal that I'm going to bring to the table, but I want to cover some of the stuff that's happened this week first, and then I'll present the deal. So don't start getting furious. Don't flip out and think you got to start paying people, hitmen with Bitcoin, to come and stop me. This is foolishness. All you're being doing, all this is teasing. You're public people. You know, let's get this out of the way. You know, the Proud Boy, Jack Buckby, Lady Alchemy, constant whining and complaining that they're under attack, just like the SJWs they claim to hate. You're public people. You're being criticized. You're being reviewed. You're putting out nonsense, and the public, aka Redbar and its fans, because you have a very small public that actually knows about you. Believe me, if Buckby, Alchemy, and the Proud Boys were mainstream news, okay? Let's pretend Buckby, Alchemy, Proud Boys, Gavin, and all them were on VH1 or Bravo or NBC, some sort of reality show about you, and all the stuff that we've uncovered about you was on mainstream TV. You'd have millions of people making fun of you, okay? That's how it works. You put out stuff that's cringe as fuck. You do things that make people want to laugh at you. People will do that. That's what's happening. So the correction shouldn't be to get rid of me, because there will be another me who takes my place because you're doing cringe shit. Do you see? That's what they don't seem to understand. And when you want to be public, when you want to be an entertainer, a performer, you're going to have people that see it and tell you what they think of it, just like you do with everything else. You guys seem to think it's okay when Sarah Silverman says something that you find cringe. It's totally okay to attack her. Or Leslie Gnomes, the big behemoth. So you understand how it works. Now you have to understand that you're not private people. You're putting out content, and people are bewildered. They're flabbergasted. Now, I know it only seems like us, but that's because we're really the only people paying attention right now. Again, if you were on mainstream TV, there would be millions. You know, just like they make fun of Bieber, Lindsay Lohan, anybody who's doing nutso stuff gets made fun of. So get over this stuff. Stop trying to defeat me and take me away. Okay? The best thing you could do to stop getting made fun of on Redbar is to stop putting out nonsense foolery. Then we have nothing to cover. So learn from it. Move on. But they really have a hard time when we make fun of Alchemy. And I think they're getting a little taste of their own medicine. You know, they want to be Western chauvinists. They want to be people who, you know, think about all of the women that they harass on a daily basis because their opinions politically differ from them. So you take any Proud Boy, go to their Twitter. Look at all that, and I'm not defending these people, but when Lena Dunham does something, it's okay for all the Proud Boys to harass her. But for some reason, when Lady Alchemy does something nuts publicly, it's not okay for me to make fun of her. And they seem to really hold her under this shield. And for a group of guys who do this to women constantly, I mean, they're literally at war with women daily. We've all seen the Gavin McInnes show. Women are the enemy. Which I agree with. You know, most women are fucking nuts. They should be servants to men. You know, that's what they were designed to be. The men's helper. The men's assistant. That's why they have a purse. It's like a PA. They're the PA for the man. And then the man could get all this stuff done. And they help the man. They're equally as important. It's just like a movie. The director of the movie, you know, couldn't do any of this without all the helpers. Women are the helpers for the men. There's nothing wrong with that. Just like there's nothing wrong with an assistant director or a showrunner or a person who, you know, the continuity girl. Even the craft service people are important. Doesn't make them less of people. You can't all have the main job. But they do protect alchemy, and I hear this all the time. Why do you make fun? We're not making fun of her because it's Buckby's wife. Okay, you understand that? There are a lot of wives I can make fun of. I don't do that. I try not to go after private people that are innocent. Alchemy got a show called Con Artist, where she goes, America. She's a mess. She's the Wiggler. And if you've seen any of her exotic dance videos, she doesn't even have talent. She literally just has a somewhat not fat body and is able to put her hair up and put makeup on and put on these costumes with wings. And really, there's no dancing involved in this. You know, he wants to say she's an artist. She is not. She is actually, I've watched the videos of her dance. She is worse than 90% of two-bit strippers that you would find at your local Rick's or your local, I love this name, Rick's for a strip club. What's the strip club called? Like the Fancy Diamond, you know, the Beautiful Rose. What's it called? Has it got a good name? No, we went with Rick's. Oh, why? This guy Rick opened it up. Oh, okay. Cool. Classy. So, and she danced at a place called Rick's. Ba ba boon. She is not a good dancer. So she puts out material and then wants to play victim and, you know, misharassed when it's made fun of. I need to make this clear again. Nobody is harassing you. You're putting out content and it's being commented on. Let's see. You're punching right, Ike. We need to always punch left. Are you talking to me? You're punching right? Is this a disgusting person here who thinks that because she's on the opposite side of the liberals who we hate right now, that we should not make fun of her? See, that's the disgusting thing that I don't think you people understand about me. I am not a servant to the right. I find them equally as despicable and disgusting as the left. I am not part of this party game that you guys have all clicked into this year. You might as well put on a VR headset and, you know, come up with an avatar, because you've all subscribed to some game that I never subscribed to play. I'm not on either side. I point out whenever somebody is being a fucking loser. That's it. At least it wasn't Dick's. Rick's Steak and Censored House. Are we having a censored problem in the chat? Can one of the admins fix that? Maybe someone could wake up Cameron and fix that. Serious question. How big is this Proud Boys group that you talk about them every week? Before 2 weeks ago, I had never heard of them. Doesn't matter how big. It matters how entertaining. I assume that's a Proud Boy. You know, the only people that have problems with you talk about them every week are the people we're talking about. They seem to think that that's some sort of an argument point. They talk about us every week. Yes. Because it's funny and you keep delivering new content. We're not, that's not an insult over here. Okay. We enjoy it. We're doing what we enjoy. You know, enough of that. They're obsessed. They talk about us every week. Fine. Believe that. But come on. You know, think about what you talk about every week. Trump, 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 Trump. So you can't knock somebody for doing the same exact things you do. And just because it's not your cup of tea and you happen to be on the receiving end of it, it doesn't make that point valid. Yes, this is the show. If I want to talk about for Proud Boys solely for the next 3 years, this is the show. People are listening to it and they like it. So stop with that argument. And if it's not your cup of tea, if you are just an average listener, hey, sometimes it's not your cup of tea. You know what's not my cup of tea? 90% of every fucking show that I listen to. Have you ever turned on a show? Odds are they're talking about some nonsense that you could give a fuck about. It's a show. What do you want me to tap into your brain and give you a direct feed of what you crave and need? Sorry. Now, I'm very close to doing that with a lot of you. Sorry that doesn't work out for everybody. We need to understand what these things are. Okay, let's see. Some people get so confused by such a simple concept. It's funny, yes. So, Lady Alchemy, there's been a lot of stuff with her. There's this Twitter account, and I hate to show it, you know. And again, this isn't me. And some of this, I got an email about alchemy that is almost too far. It's almost too much. It's almost digging into these people too much where it's just, you know, you see some people that they do. They want to hurt others. And I realized this even when, you know, we had that thing with Mountain where he's online. I don't want to hurl my insults at these people. My goal isn't to bully and torment. Now, I understand that that's a casualty of making fun of these people, but I bring it back to the beginning again. And it really is a through line throughout my whole life. I remember this in school. Whenever I was the king of making fun of people in school. But I never did it alone. It wasn't because I was a pussy. It's because that's not my bag. I don't get my kicks from going up to some kid in the hallway, just me and him, and saying mean shit to him to ruin his day and then push him into a locker and walk away. That's a psychotic bully. That's somebody who wants to hurt somebody. That was never my thing. My thing is, hey, we're all around, you guys. This is fun. We're having fun. Now, why is there always a victim? Well, risk and victims make for the best comedy. You know, I was thinking about this the other day, too. Almost every good joke, almost all stand-up comedy, is basically the same thing we're doing here. But they're just too pussy to name a name. So, like, you could watch stand-up comedy, and a lot of stand-up comedy is making jokes about human behaviors. Or certain groups of people who possess these behaviors, and what they don't do in comedy, what they tend to not do is like actually go after one person and make fun of all the things he does, okay? But they still make fun of all those behaviors without naming the name of the guy. Next time you watch any stand-up comedy, pay attention. Now imagine, you know, even Pete Holmes does it. Even the softest comedians are making fun of the behaviors. Now imagine if those guys just tied it to a guy who possesses those behaviors. Then it would be, oh, that guy's picking on a guy. No, no, no. We use the guy as an example. It makes it funnier than if I just said, you know, like short people that get angry. Like imagine Buckby. We make fun of Buckby. Buckby's short, he's angry, look what he's doing. But imagine if I left the name Buckby out of it and just started riffing on the behavior, it wouldn't really connect with people as much. You wouldn't have that example. Wouldn't be as funny. The risk, gone. So you get criticized a lot when you do that, and people will call this something other than comedy. They'll call it easy, or, you know, there's no content involved in this. It is the exact same thing. Now, again, imagine I take these people out of it and still talk about what they do. You would think this is great comedy. Oh, look at this. So that's all we do. We just say the guy's name and use them as a vessel to investigate all their errors and bring them up as examples. It's just easier to do it that way. It's more fun, more organic too. You have a guy, you never know what he's going to bring to the table, then you witness it and you all laugh, and then you're following the storyline. And then, you know, who was it that I said, you know, it was some guy, some Proud Boy, you know, was messaging me and saying, hey, can you just lay off the Proud Boys? You know, it's every week with the Proud Boys. And just like somebody said in the chat, we've created a storyline here. The storyline can't go out like a match in 1 second. The storyline has to die out by itself. So when you ask, why do I cover these guys week to week? It's because it's a part of an ongoing storyline. Now, it's not my fault that that storyline hasn't sizzled out. That's not my fault. That's up to the universe. If I just stopped one of our storylines, you can't go 4 weeks covering this madness and then just stop. It's a curse. So, you know, these are storylines and they go beyond the people eventually. Okay, I know that's hard for some people to swallow, but that's what's really happening here. All of the people that we start, all of the fools, all of the people that we bring up on the show, they become a character. They become this storyline. And all of the things that we say about them, they might not even be true. It's not about truth. Again, this is a comedy show. It's not a court of law. So what happens is we come up with concepts. We come up with ideas. We have hopes for what our fools will do next. And we could be wrong all the time. But we're trying to predict what the fool will do next, you see? So Patrick Melton will keep, for instance, he'll keep going, they said I was never going to raise enough money for Edinburgh, and then I did. That's wonderful. But we were making predictions based off the character that we became accustomed to. So when we're wrong, it's not, it doesn't ruin the bit. Being wrong has nothing to do with it. Being right has nothing to do with it. Being entertained has everything to do with it. Shout out! So I hope this clears it up for some people. These are the stories that are near and dear to our heart right now. And yes, some of them go away and new ones come up. They're long form. Okay? It's episodic. Just like your TV shows. You know, did anybody tune into Breaking Bad and go, geez, again with the meth? Is that all that goes on in this guy's life? Dealing meth and he almost gets caught? Come on. Come up with something original. It's like, this is original. How many fools do I need? How many years have to go by? How many laughs had to be had until you people get it? So I don't want to hear this as an argument anymore. All they do is obsess. Yes, it's one of our stories this year. Just like, you know, take Tales from the Crypt, one of my favorite shows. Tales from the Crypt, you know, how many episodes do they have? 8 episodes? Each episode is a different story, that's it. They obsess. I don't know, bad example maybe, but come on. Mike, there's one thing you haven't considered. A cornered, fat, fat beast bites the hardest. What does that mean? Kind of nihilist. Yes, crystal clear. Great. So with that being said, I'd like to continue Our Lady Alchemy coverage. And the best part about this particular storyline here that has gotten a little out of control is Jack Buckby, of course, is engaged to Lady Alchemy. And we read this engagement post of his last week where he becomes furious, enraged when people call her a stripper instead of exotic dancer. And again, if I took that scenario and wrote it and changed the names and made a little fucking sketch out of it, then they would say, oh, look at this creative guy making comedy. It's the same exact thing. We're just talking about the real guy. It should mean more. So Jack Buckby, he gets completely upset when everybody calls her a stripper. And so this guy on Twitter, no relation to me. I don't know who this guy is. He started going nuts, posting pictures proving that she is a stripper. I'm getting message after message saying she worked at a strip club called Rick's and was fired for having sex with one of the guys who comes in. If they're engaged, stop. Is this guy a Proud Boy? Mike, it's our narrative, not theirs. Fools are unlimited supply. Burn the witch. Huzzah. I don't know what these things mean. They met for the first time in real life 2 months ago. The engagement is a sheme. It could be. Could be. I mean, Buckby could be using her at least to get his visa into America so he could finally be the entrepreneur that he's always wanted to be. And I have a deal with Buckby. So, Buckby, if you're listening and you're enraged, I read your message this morning. That's a hint. I got a message. Okay, this will keep the fish this will keep you on the line. I got a private message today on Facebook from the real Jack Buckby. A private message, a couple paragraphs even. And I'm going to read this to you coming up in the show. And we're going to compose a deal. And we're going to compose another deal with the Prouds. Did I show you this? Okay, before we go into alchemy, because we got some great alchemy, did I show you this? This was, I believe this happened right after our last show. I believe this happened this week. Gavin brought up something about Buckby quitting. Remember last episode we covered that Buckby has quit the Proud Boys. And we're like, he'll be back, he'll be back. Now we have it kind of even more officially. Check out this clip from the Grove and Magrana show. I like Gavin. I think he's cool. I think he said, as soon as he grew that beard back, I like him a little bit more. Anybody else? Remember Gavin shaved his beard and it was like the respect for him went right out the window. Now that he grew the beard back to where I like it, I like exactly where his beard is at right now. Seems like he's not as bad. Not as bad of a guy. So here it is. Look at this clip. This is a fun clip. Jack Buckby officially quits Proud Boys. Let's hear it from Gavin, the leader of the Proud Boys himself. Let's hear what he has to say.
Yo, dog.
No.
Oh, there was a caller. I'll set this up. So somebody calls in to ask Gavin a question. Let me bump up the vowel on there. Here we go.
Yo, dog.
No. Hey, I wanted to know what you thought about Jack Buckby saying that he's going to start a new Proud Boys division and that he's going to change his name and get a new identity for 2017. Like, what the hell is that all about?
No, no, he's quitting. He's gone. He's not a Proud Boy anymore. He owns the Proud Boy.
Wow, so listen to that. He's quitting. He's gone. He's not a Proud Boy anymore. That was almost Gavin's attempt at desperately pleading with Buckby to come back. I think Gavin knows that most of the Proud Boys are these weird. And if somebody could get footage. Again, I can't stop because there's so many fun things to show you. They had a meetup in Times Square. I'm not kidding. Like six guys came out and they picketed in Times Square. It was the most foolish thing I've ever seen. If anyone can find a clip of that. And I got a message from a guy who was at the meetup. You're not going to believe what he said. But I believe that without Buckby, Gavin realizes there's not many like human beings, you know, and we make fun of Buckby a lot, but at least, you know, the guy dresses himself, he brushes his hair and he doesn't look like, not to offend any Proud Boys, there's nothing wrong with it, but you're talking about Gavin McInnes. This is a guy, $4 million in the bank. He's on Fox News. He can't be hanging around with a bunch of guys who look like patrons of a place called Rick's. Shout outs to Rick's. And most Proud Boys, and this isn't a slam against them, okay? So don't take the slam. Most Proud Boys look like guys who, you know, they go on pontoon boats with their friend Greg, you know. They look like guys who enjoy fishing and going to, like car shows in a parking lot in some small city. I don't know if I'm describing them right. You know, just cheap guys, you know, who look like they shop at Walmart. Cheap looking, scruffy, slightly overweight guys, right? Isn't that what they look like? So I think Gavin knows he needs some like upper class Proud Boys. And Jack Buckby is the closest thing he's got to that. You know, Jack Buckby wears a suit. He's well spoken. You know, but he's 22 years old. Should a 46-year-old guy even be addressing? No, he quit my group. You know, Jack Buckby is too young for Gavin to even email him back. That's what I would say. I would say he's too young and too much of a nothing. Why are you even talking to these people? So here it is again. Listen to this. This is Gavin talking. And every week, I send Gavin the same message. Truce? You want to do a truce this week? Nothing back. I give him an opportunity every week to admit how crazy this is. You know, he was emailing me again. Did you call Andrew Kaster and get him fired from his job? No, and I guarantee he didn't get fired. You know, they always want to claim that, oh, I've been fired from my job. Did you really? One call got you fired from your job from an anonymous person? I find that hard to believe. I would never do that. And you've got Gavin emailing me. Did you call this guy? And I write to him. I go, first of all, no. And second of all, what are you doing? You're a grown man with three kids and a wife and $4 million in the bank. And you're emailing me on a Saturday asking if I've called a guy's work to get him fired. I don't know what kind of world you live in, but I don't live in a world where we're even dealing with that. I'm 34 years old. I might seem very petty, but it's a show. And I keep telling people, this is a show. In my real life, I'm worried about workout supplements. I'm not sitting around going, who could I get fired? It's insane. So the fact that this suited millionaire deals with this kind of stuff makes me believe he's nuts. Therefore, great guy to bring up on the show. Okay, here's this vigil. Gavin at the Proud Boys vigil. Vigil. Sorry. Sorry about the volume. We'll watch that in a second. Okay, let's watch this again. Here's Gavin's clip about the Proud Boys, and we get a shout-out in this. Remember, I'm invisible to Gavin.
Identity for 2017. Like, what the hell is that all
about?
No,
he's quitting. He's gone. He's not a Proud Boy anymore. He owns the Proud Boy Mag URL. I want to try to get that content from him get it back to the Canadian guys, do a redirect.
So just like Vice, Gavin's partner, second in command, Jack Buckby, has now run off with the Proud Boy magazine name. Jack Buckby is the one who runs the website. Now Gavin's got to get it back from him. Same old story.
But he was asked to leave. No, he wasn't asked to leave. He was basically harassed by that sliver on the far right. Pots and pans.
He was harassed.
Bang, 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 bang. Just like social justice warriors. And eventually he goes, I don't want to deal with this anymore. I'm out. So this sliver of Nazis that I'm in shit for kicking out lost us our vice president. Redbar, I'm sure, was a factor too.
Oh, but shout out. What was that?
Redbar was a factor too.
So here's Jack Buckby. You know, these guys could make fun of liberals all day, and then when they get made fun of for basically nothing, by the way. You know, any strong person would not let this bother them. Because, yeah, it's like, we're making fun of you for being short, temperamental, cringe. Who cares? You can't look past that. You can't go, you know, some people are going to interpret this as cringe. Who cares? No, but we keep doing it. You're like my little brother when I was... 10, and he was whatever 3 years less than 10 was. The reaction when they get mad, when they get temperamental about this stuff, it feeds into it. It's like you want to do it more. You know, it's like with Josh Denny. Josh Denny, this guy, this fool that we used to make fun of all the time, he got this show on the Food Network, Ginormous Food. And when we first heard about this, we were giddy. We couldn't wait to make fun of him. And throughout the year, Josh Denny kind of proved that he didn't care when we made fun of him. You know, he would message me, and even though he was a con artist and a cringe god and all this stuff, he didn't react to it in a deceiving, mad, butthurt way. And it took all of the want out of making fun of him right out of me. To the point where the premiere episode of Ginormous Food aired, which we were waiting for an entire 6 months. We couldn't wait to make fun of him. And it aired, and I go, it doesn't do anything for me anymore. I don't want to make fun of him. He handles it too well. So that's the secret. Handle it well. Show that you're not an emotional cripple deep down inside who's putting on a front. And nobody wants to make fun of you. I've said it for, since the beginning of time, the people who get made fun of over and over again are the people who ask the universe to make fun of them. They refuse to put any responsibility on themselves to get better or to not care. And they ask people to do it in this weird way. And we know that. And we feed off of it. And everybody does it too. You know, even the people who are against making fun of people are making fun of somebody. Just a person that, you know, society has agreed it's okay to do to. You know, like Trump. You know, for all those people, you know, who are so against what Trump does, they wouldn't do the same thing to him that they're so against. It would be beneath them. But they make fun of Trump for being orange. You know, the most serious people in the world are making fun of him for being orange. That should be beneath them. So everybody does it. And everybody does it to somebody who is being asked to do it. They're throwing it out there in the universe. They're saying, please, here's the ammo. Load it up and fling it at me. What was my point? Okay, so let's back it up here. And listen, is this a guy? Oh, yeah, he gave Redbar the credit for Buckby leaving the Proud Boys. And this is what happened. Mr. Tough Buckby, who claims he doesn't care, he's been being made fun of so many times a day by not just Redbar, but Proud Boys and all these people. And why is he getting made fun of all the time? Is it because everybody's just out to get him? No, it's because he's making errors. So the world is responding to what he's putting out correctly. Now, when you've got the Proud Boys making fun of him and us, I think that's time to buy a saddle. I think that's time for him to look at himself and go, okay, I'm getting made fun of by all different types of people. So maybe they're not out to get me. Maybe I'm putting something out there for them to make fun of. And Buckby has quit the Proud Boys. Why did he quit the Proud Boys, this group that he claimed to be so loyal to? This magazine that he started, why did he quit? And again, right now, I want to remind everybody, pretend it's not about Buckby. Isn't this information, isn't what we're uncovering, doesn't it apply to millions of people? Doesn't Buckby represent millions of people with doing the same thing that he's doing? That's what I want you to take away from this show. When you go, he's still on Buckby, he's still on the Proud Boys. No, no, no. I'm still on this behavior, this unsolved behavior. Buckby is just the example of the day. Voila! So, Buckby has quit the Proud Boys. Now, why did he quit the Proud Boys, a group that he loves? Because he can't take being made fun of. He wanted to be in the spotlight and do whatever he wants, but he wasn't able to accept the consequences of that. I tell people this every day. I especially say it to the anonymous people that want to talk shit. And this is what I don't like when anonymous people talk shit. I feel like you should. If you're going to talk shit, you should always do it under your real name. Why? Because then you're responsible for the consequences that come with making fun of people. So when I go after the Proud Boys, there could be consequences. They come back at me. And if you're not prepared for consequences, you're not fit to be in this game of publicly speaking your opinion or publicly putting something out there. And everybody from Britney Spears to me to Buckby needs to be prepared for what's to come after you put something out. So you put something out there, and if a large amount of people are making fun of you every day about it, that should be information that you're using to change things. You see? You should be taking that as, you know, like they do when they come out with when Nabisco, these fucks, come out with a new cracker. What is the first thing Nabisco does? They get a couple of fucking retards together in a group, and they hire some company to give them this new cracker, and then they ask them what they think about it, and then they use those opinions as research, you know, market research, and they decide, well, is this cracker good or bad? So when you're getting made fun of more than you're getting complimented, you need to take that as market research and start changing some things. I do it every day, behind the scenes. Nobody will know what I change. Nobody will know what I don't change. Secret. just like a company would keep something top secret. Now, the pussies are the ones who claim that they're not affected ever. You hear this all the time.
I don't give a shit what anyone says. Why would I listen to that?
And then they clearly listen and give a shit, and they're defensive. And instead of just changing the thing that everyone's making fun of, they either decide to get defensive and to argue it all day, like you see Millman doing, or they bow out. And in Jack's case, he has bowed out. He has quit the Proud Boys, not because there's a problem with Proud Boys, but because he realized when being a public figure, you're getting all this shit, and he couldn't take it. And I have proof that he couldn't take it. Coming up, let's finish off this Gavin McInnes stuff.
I'm out. So this sliver of Nazis that I'm in shit for kicking out lost us our vice president. Redbar, I'm sure, was a factor too. But yeah, these fucking boring nuts who attacked Jack just made him leave. And I think
Jack needs to get a fucking spine. Come on,
there
he
you go.
Just talk on the internet.
Needs to get a spine. You know, Gavin's gonna sit there and go, yeah, they made him leave. You know, these pieces of shit made him leave. And then the caller, what does the caller say? Jack needs to get a spine. You do. And you know what? When you have a spine, you don't get made fun of. They saw the weakness in Jack. They made fun of him, and Jack proved to be the weak person. Proud Boys all hate him now. They're all talking shit. He bad ass. 100% agree about the manufactured alpha status. They learn to talk the talk, but the minute it gets a bit real, they fold. Yeah, and sometimes, it's always going to hurt. And it's okay for things to hurt. But you got to sit up at night and go, how do I stop the things that happened yesterday from happening today? And if you're not correcting and making a better life for yourself, you're a fucking idiot. And you're going to keep getting made fun of. Now, the second you correct and get better, people stop making fun. It's as easy as that.
Just bail on the Proud Boys like he can't just bail on us like that.
He did.
The Proud Boys got to stick together. Gavin, you, me, everybody. We got to unite. It's been about unity. And now he's just ditching us and changing his identity like a little weasel.
This caller's a prank.
Oh, no, Gavin.
No. You sound like a spy. All right, let's talk to... by the way, Proud Boys meeting this Wednesday. We're going to do it in Times Square. Before we go to the bar...
Okay, every day is a Proud Boys meeting. And we got to show you, finally, we got some footage here. I got to pee again. You know, I've been doing this thing. Apparently, I'm on this health kick. And by the way, you can't see any results right now, which I'm kind of pissed about. I've been on this health kick since January 1st. I started a little earlier. I guess it hasn't been that long, 13 days. But January 1st is when I really started hardcore on this health kick. And I'm talking about I am eating all the right foods at all the right times. I'm doing all the right workouts at all the right times. And I'm taking all the right supplements at all the right times. Besides this wine for today. But this is a celebration. It's Friday the 13th. Tomorrow's my birthday, everybody. So I'm allowed to drink wine once a week for the show, for you. But I've been following everything. And my face has actually become fatter. And this happened the first health kick I took as well, where it was like 4 months where the better I ate and the more I worked out, the fatter my face got. Now, I don't know what that is. I have been Googling it like a madman. And it is the worst. This doesn't even look like me. I've been trying everything. And now I drink a lot of water. And I get a lot of water in my diet. And I Googled it again. How much water should you be drinking a day? And now they're saying 3.7 liters a day for a guy over 19. So I go, okay, I'll try it. Even though I think that's ridiculous. I think that how could it possibly be that the human body was designed to be drinking water every 5 seconds of the day? I mean, up until, you know, how many years ago? It was impossible. Where would you find that much water? Where were people who didn't have fucking stores and clean tap water, finding all this water to drink 3.7 liters a day. I mean, that would be excessive. You'd be laughed out of the Wild West if you said, oh, I must die. I got to keep water with me and drink it all day. They'd be like, you can't. That's a luxury that you can't afford. But now I've done it. So this is a liter bottle, and I'll drink three of these a day and get the rest of the water from food. And hopefully that will cut down on the puffiness of my face, which is, it's ridiculous. You do all this work and your face gets fatter. It doesn't make a lick of sense. Yeah, somebody says you don't need that much water. Again, I agree with you. And usually I just drink water whenever I need to drink water, whenever I'm thirsty. That's the way I feel that it should be. But why is my face so fucking puffy? So now I'm going to do the 3.7 liters, like they say, and we'll see how that works. We're going to test it for a week. This week I have also cut out butter to see if maybe that is the culprit. And then if it doesn't do anything by next week, we'll try something else. So that's what we're doing. But the reason I bring it up, the peeing. And I even bought this beautiful Camelback water bottle so that I know this is a liter. Just do three of these a day. You'll be good. So we'll try that. Even though I believe it's nonsense. Mike, people didn't have 3.7 liters of censored McDonald's back in the day either. Cool. The fuck kind of comment is that? They drank weak beer. Water makes us swell up, somebody says. Okay, that's against all the research I've read this week. You need to chug naked juice like Bubba. Rule of thumb, drink a little more than just when you're thirsty. Sure. Again, I understand all of these rules, and I read all the same shit that you read, and I find it very offensive when people try to... I've heard all the arguments, but you got to try all of them to know which ones work. So you got to try it. You can't just say it doesn't work until you try it. So I'm going to now try the excessive water method. I'm not saying, oh, I'm so stupid. I'm believing in this. I'm just saying I'm going to try it because I haven't tried 3.7 liters a day. And I understand all of those things. But the side effect is I got to fucking piss so bad right now. I hate to take a break to pee, but I got to take a break to pee. Okay? Just a little tinkle, and we'll be right back. What was I going to do? What was I on pace to do? Oh, yeah, we're going to watch the Proud Boy meetup. We're going to see what happened at the Proud Boy meetup that he just talked about, this big Times Square meetup. When we come back, it looks like we've got video footage of that, which I'm really excited about. Let me find the break song. The peeing thing is a big deal when you're drinking this much water. So we got to find a way to... Really, if there was a way to just piss this shit out right here, I would do it. Or let me find a good song for you. Mountain Drink Sour Cream. Yes, I believe that. Drink the pee. Yes, creatine makes the face puffy. Does it really? I know it bloats, but does it bloat the face? And I've tried on and off creatine. I'm only doing creatine before workouts now. Diets are 99% placebo. I mean, that's the most insane thing I've ever heard. Don't worry about it. I don't want to argue with all this information. I've got it. Mike, you should just simply hunt all your food. Go find elk in Chicago. It's meditative. It's a Joe Rogan joke. Drinking that much water only makes sense if you're sweating it all out. LOL, he's taking a smoke break? No. I would never do that. In fact, I will be so quick that you know there's no smoke. I would never fucking lie to you like that. Remember I said I don't smoke on the show anymore? I'm done with smoking. You know, and people, they want to come up with ideas like that in their head because they're that weak. I am able to stop something immediately and change the course of my life like that. I know that might be remarkable to some folks out there, but not me. I have learned over and over again that you can make a decision and just stop. I've done it many times. There was no sneak smoke breaking. If I were to fail and need a cigarette, I would do it right in front of you. I would never lie to you like that. Get that out of your head. I'm going to pee, and I will be so quick that even if I was sneaking a smoke, it would be so quick and ridiculous that it would be gay. I'll be right back with more on today's Redbar show. Friday the 13th. It's Big Sean.
Sex game at ass blowing me.
We'll be right back.
Sex game at ass texting me.
We're gonna
me
watch
up
their yeah meetup.
I got the moves. I got the moves. I'm making moves. You gotta move.
You gotta move.
She made that back move.
Damn.
She made the titties move.
Damn.
I made the city move.
Like, whoa.
I made the city move. I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I got the moves.
I got the moves.
I'm making moves.
I'm making moves.
You gotta move.
You gotta.
She made that back move.
Damn.
She made the titties move.
Goddamn.
I made the city move.
I do.
I made the city move.
I do.
Look, give me the ball and I won't have to pass it. I ain't passing out till I'm asthmatic.
Wow.
I take a play and then I back to back and hit after hit, check the batting average. I take the work, flip it acrobatic. Got a little time and a lot of talent. Do a little talking and a lot of action. Seen a competition, not a challenge. I lean, I move, I walk through in this bitch. Packed out, but I can count on my hands. So I'ma talk to in this bitch. Girls from law school in this bitch. Yeah, they paralegals. Barely 21, that's very legal. But they doing shit that's probably barely legal. Oh, man, it's that nigga that you probably least suspected. I just had a couple dots and he connected. Now you're top five getting redirected. From here on out, it'll be consecutive. We making moves like Tarantino, like J.J. Abrams. Moving like Channing Tatum. Moving like Jason Statham. Motherfuck the whole industry. Half of these niggas my enemies. I got this bitch going off more than breaking and entering. You hot for a minute, me. I make this shit that lasts for infinity. Hop in the booth, man, that shit like a gym to me. Don't test the agility. Silly, silly thinking that the negativity you talking could ever fuck up the tranquility.
See, that's not enough time to have any sort of cigarette. And you should appreciate the breaks on the show. I run and I quickly pee. You know, you listen to Legion of Skanks, they're gone for 45 minutes sometimes, okay? You should appreciate the short break. Hey, welcome. It's Redbar. We're back. We're going to show you some of this footage. I haven't seen this yet of this meetup. Well, I saw a clip from it. Oh, I wanted to... What was I going to plug? I was just going to plug something. Oh, yeah. We got some heat coming up. What's heat? We got new merch on the way. Okay, maybe next week, maybe a week and a half. And we haven't put out any new merch since we joined Kumia. If you could believe it or not, I know you saw we did have a restock on the Redbar dad hat. And we still have a few left if you want to get these. Redbarradio.net/store. $20 for the version one of the Redbar dad hat. A very popular item. So we did have a restock, but we haven't come out with anything new since we joined Kumia. And how we do merch around here is a little bit differently. What I like to do is I only put out merch when I'm inspired to do so. And we like to put out really dope shit that's not just our logo thrown on a shirt. You know, it's always inspired by something. And it's always very high quality and actual shit that you could wear that's not just a brand name on a shirt. So it's almost like a line of clothing that you could wear, you know. And this concept came, you know, a couple reasons this concept came. First of all, it's cooler just to wear dope shit. If you're going to be spending money on something, it should be something that you would want to wear. It should be, oh, this is also an addition to my wardrobe, not just... buying it because it's got the logo. But it also came from, you know, after 13 years of doing this and selling merch and making your living, you know, almost solely off merch and bonus content. You know, we don't do ads here and we don't take salaries. So we sell merch and you can't just keep selling people your logo on something over and over and over again. So we had to get creative and come up with stuff. And now it's evolved into... You know, it's something always different, something that you're always going to want. And we do it a different way. You know, we've done it all different ways. But the way we do it now is the merch comes out by surprise, like a Beyonce album. You never know when it's going to drop. And when it does, it's only available for a very limited time. So you have to get it then and you'll never be able to get it again. So keep an eye out. Follow me on Twitter. Join the mailing list at redbarradio.net or follow me on Facebook. You'll know about it when it comes out, but it could only be up for 24 hours to 3 days, and that's it. And then we ship them out. And I will give you a hint on this merch. I believe we're doing two items that are meant to be bought together. Two items. These items, both, we're upping the quality even higher than we've ever done. So if you've bought something from us before and you liked the quality, or you didn't think it was good enough, this one is better. It's about, I would say, 39% better quality than the last one. And we are going with a new company that cost me a lot more money, but it's supposed to be a lot better quality. Now, I know you're going to love the design on this new merch. I know it's going to look dope, and I know it's going to be perfect for coming up. The other thing about our merch is when you wear it out, it's fucking new. It's relevant, okay? You might not know it, but it ain't 2005 shit. It ain't old shit. And people in the know, they see you walking down the street wearing, they go, what is that shit? And the other point I want to make, this is how this show stays afloat. So if you like this show, let's say you're a person who doesn't need dope merch, remember, this is how we stay afloat. So always consider merch to be also a show of support to the show to keep it on the air. We have decided that you're important enough where we don't sell you fucking nonsense via advertisements. So once in a great while, we put out merch and we ask that you fucking buy it up. Okay, that's what I want to see. When we drop this merch, I want to see people buy it. Okay, because we need the money. We need to support the show somehow, and ads are just not the way to do it. So that's coming. So save your cash. You'll never know when it drops, but I'm saying put some money aside for that Red Bar Heat, because this is going to be a good one. This is going to be dope as shit. Okay, let's play this video of this meetup, because I saw a clip from it on the Gavin McGrinnis show, and I couldn't believe my eyes, and hopefully he covers it more. Let me just do a skim. Okay, yeah, here it is. Okay, let's see. He's talking about... Oh, wait. Oh, it's the whole thing. Okay, let's watch this. Here it is, Rebel Media. Lauren Southern, by the way, has been painting on eyebrows. Have you noticed this? This poor girl, she really needs some style advice. Because she could. I mean, you fix up... I could make Lauren Southern look 60% better than she looks. But boy, is this girl lost like a Proud Boy. Just like a Proud Boy. Stuck in trying to emulate what was cool in high school, but doesn't really have a clue. She is now painting on these brown fucking oil eyebrows. Rebel Media. Here we go. This is Gavin's Proud Boys meetup. Let's see what transpires. Chef!
So when Trump said that we were going to get tired of winning, we thought, all right, I can handle being a little tired.
Okay, let me set this up for audio, people. Here's Gavin talking to the camera in Times or Times Square in New York City at night. He now wears, okay, I got to talk about this. He started wearing, I'm not kidding, he started wearing a cloak. Now, maybe he's not wearing it in this video, but I'm not fucking kidding. I think it was on Wednesday's show, and if somebody can get me a clip of this, because this is big, he is wearing his Fred Perry polo shirt, you know, the skinhead polo shirt, and over it, a black cloak. And I'm not kidding. He even called it a cloak. On Thursday's show. So on Wednesday's show, he wore a cloak. And then on Thursday's show, he wore something very similar. And he goes, oh man, did I just wear this yesterday? I just wore this cloak the other day. He's wearing a cloak as the leader of the Proud. I'm not kidding. Now, if you don't think that's fucking nuts, that he's wearing cloaks. Cloak! You know who else wears a cloak? I don't know. Grim Reaper, people in cults, sadistic Satanists. Who wears a cloak? Cloaks are totally in, Mike. Yes, what? Okay. Get me the Gavin McGinnis show from Wednesday. He wears a cloak now. No more suits. Cloaks. Yes, C-L-O-A-K. We'll watch this. I'm not kidding. I can't believe it's happening either. Okay. All right, let's settle down. Let's watch the Proud Boy meetup, and then I'll show you the cloak stuff.
And then we got winning, 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 until We got sick of winning. So sick, we got winning AIDS. It's been too many victories, and we can't take it anymore.
So he's in Times Square. I'm not kidding. They're holding a vigil. Vigil. Gavin is holding a picket sign with Donald Trump's face on it, and he's surrounded by Proud Boys, Lonely Boys, all holding picket signs as well, and candles. And I think there's only like seven people there. The great Gavin McInnes was able to pull seven people. And they're chanting and singing in Times Square, and they're bothering people. Okay, this is really happening.
We got, first of all, we won. That was a bit
long. Look at the Proud Boys.
What did we get? Mad Dog Mattis.
This is what, 46-year-old, he's an accomplished guy. And he's hanging around, and no offense to these guys. It's not about these guys being that shit, but why is Gavin hanging around 22-year-old lost? And maybe they're not lost. Maybe they are. This could be fun to some people. You know, again, I got to rephrase. It really isn't their fault. But even they should realize, really? It's like the seven of us nobodies and Gavin's hanging out with just us? That's a little weird. Like, think about it. What accomplished guy would do that? And I'm not saying that you're even beneath him, but he's a 46-year-old man with a family. Why is he doing this? It's very, very odd. And it's not like the entertainment that you're getting from it is worth it. It's not like anybody is like, fuck yeah, you know, he makes sacrifices for comedy's sake. This isn't funny. It's terrible.
Sounds like you're announcing a wrestler when you mention his name.
Okay, here's the truth. There are eight people there, and I have a message from one of the guys who was there. I guess I'll read that to you right now. Let's see this. Let me just find it. Buck me email about Proud. I got so much stuff on these guys this week. Proud Boy parody cover. Oh, yeah, we got to play that. Buck me quitting. Proud Boy meetup message. Here we go. I've edited out the guy's name because he asked me to edit it out. But listen to this. So this is the meetup he was talking about. Mike, you were right. The Proud Boys are psychotic. I went to their meetup tonight to say what's up and got questioned on why I was posting in the Redbar group. Before I got murdered, I dipped out. This thing had gone way too far. I feel like that movie I watched in middle school called The Wave. Gavin needs to disavow the Proud Boys. And I get messages like this all the time. Mike, you were right about the Proud Boys. All right, here we go. Here's the meetup that this guy was at. Eight people confirmed.
Then what do we get? The cruise. GM has to make the cruise in America. And what's this here? Tucker Carlson, 9 p.m., primetime slot. Roasting social justice warriors is now a primetime event. And of course, the Dow.
Look at these
this
guys.
This ancient photograph of 19,000. I think it's 19,995. It's probably 20,000 by the time you see
this.
The
highest it got to, 19,999.63.
19,999.6. We can't take it anymore, Mr. Trump. Stop the winning. We are going to flatline.
Please.
And then today, with this CNN reporter getting told it's fake news, we lost a lot of good men to winning when he said that. We had some guys that were in intensive care, and as soon as you said, you're fake news, it went beep, beep, beep.
That's it.
Hi, folks, that was a Rebel Media short. I have my own show.
That was, you have your own show. We know. Gavin, please come back to us. Every week I ask him. Even in this email, I wish, you know, I could pull it up, but this email where he accused me of, did you call this guy's work? And I said to him, no, obviously not. And I go, Gavin, please, how much more evidence do you need that this is nonsense? I mean, you're making it where you'll never be able to come back from this. And he's getting made fun of by all sorts of groups of people. I mean, we're probably in the minority of people that make fun of Gavin McInnes, to be honest. You want to talk about the alt-right, like the real evil guys. They're all piling on Gavin. And it goes on and on. And
how's it going?
Like I said, you think that I cover it a lot here. I could cover it a lot more. I mean, I could probably do 8 hours a day on this stuff by the stuff that I get sent here. So we ask again, Gavin, we're pleading with you to come back. There is no shame in being wrong. There is only shame in doing the wrong thing over and over and over again because you don't want to be looked at as wrong. There is nothing wrong with being wrong as long as you correct it. He refuses to correct. Let me show you this. And it seems like I am Italian. See, I don't know what to necessarily do with all the information I get. So while it seems like I have an agenda, you know, to bring down these guys, I really don't. It's just I want to cover all the stuff that people gave me. You see? So it's tough. It does look like I am obsessed in trying to bring them down. I don't need them to be brought down. It would be nice to have Gavin back. How cool would it be? I wanted to be on a network where it's like, damn, we got Kumia, we got Gavin, we got me. Let's build this shit up. Let's make it dope. Let's make it actually good. He refuses. He refuses to have a... He could have a great show. Gavin could really have one of the best shows out there. But he's alienating, you know, 98% of people who don't want this cultish, weird, alt-right Trump. I mean, what you just saw is not what people want. A very small sliver, like he says, wants that. And it's an obsessed, disgusting, you know, whacked out again. This whole Trump thing has put people on these paths. Whether it's the liberals, the alt-right, the right. I mean, you see it. Go on Twitter. This is all these people live for. And it doesn't do a thing for their lives. They're not even learning about themselves through this. I mean, it might be the most tremendous waste of time I've seen in all my life, this Trump thing. How it swept America into this, you know. The Beanie Baby fad is nothing compared to what Trump has done to these people's minds. For that reason alone, I would say we need to get rid of Trump to end this. Unless this is a growing pain for people. Maybe Trump needed to come along for people to expose their errors. And maybe 5 years from now, we'll look back at this and go, remember when the world showed how truly irrational they are? When Trump came along. And then maybe everybody will learn from it. Maybe it's just necessary. It's one of Lady Alchemy's songs that she dances to. What was I going to show you now? Asian Mike? What's going on? Are my eyes getting... This has been happening a lot too with my health kick. My eyes constantly burning and swollen and on fire. I tried taking allergy medicine the other day. Believe me, I am trying everything. Yeah, my eyes are burning. Is that what you were talking about? Trump, yeah. God, I managed 2 minutes of safe space. Don't make fun of safe space. Tlaib is an innocent. I don't watch safe space. That way I can't say anything bad about it. It's just easier for me to not watch. What did I want to show you next? It was something to do with Proud Boys. What did I say? His tweets, his feats. Mark, you peel bananas the wrong way. That could be true. Yeah, I always have a hard time. Whenever I peel a banana, I get one going, and then the other one takes all of the rest of the peel. Asian Mark Fenoya. Mike, you're ODing on creatine, bro. That's not true. I'm taking 2,500 milligrams pre-workout. I saw somebody else say, how much creatine are you taking? So the workout days are Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. So Monday's chest. Monday is chest. Tuesday is back and biceps. Thursday is shoulders. And this is all free weights, body weight exercises, no machines. And then Saturday or Sunday is leg day. You know, just because of the conflict, I would do shoulders Friday and legs Wednesday or Thursday, but because of the show. I can't. And before workouts, I am only taking 2,500 grams or milligrams, whatever they count it as, of creatine. That's it. And only on workout days. And then none on the others. And that's just for the pump. So yeah, I'm not taking too much creatine. Believe me, I research all of this stuff. I'm very invested in it. So I do get insulted when people think that I'm some noob to information like this. There is meth in those pre-workouts. No, I'm not taking pre-workout. I'm taking the most organic, straight, clean creatine. Okay? I'm not taking extreme 360 with a guy with a bicep and a lightning bolt and all that stuff with a bunch of other stuff in it. No. I'm not taking any of that. I'm taking the cleanest, most natural, pure supplements you could take. Is that okay? This is Sounding Joe Rogany. I'm just responding to the people in the chat. No tries, abs, or cardio? Well, tries are on the chest day. Those come with chest. So yeah, there's a tricep exercise on chest day, and most chest exercises are working out your triceps plenty. And abs is core, and that comes with every full body weight exercise, working your abs. The days of just working your abs, I mean, that's very, down the line. That's when everything else is sculpted, yeah, then you could take an ab day. But ab day, I mean, that's 90s. You don't focus on your abs. You should be doing full body workouts that kind of hit everything, and your abs will be just where they need to be in relation to everything else. You shouldn't be isolating your abs, really, unless you're, trying to be a male model. I believe, right? Yes, I said pre-workout. Yes, people very... You know what I noticed about health, nutrition, and exercise? Everybody thinks they're an expert, and they fail to realize that there's... Not only are there a million ways of doing everything that work, there are also a million things that are wrong. There's not one right way to do it. There are a million right ways to work out and to be healthy. And that's what everybody, it's just like with music. You need to understand that it doesn't work for everybody. Okay? So I understand. Anytime you bring this up, you get everybody with their opinion telling you how it's supposed to be done. And again, you know what? Maybe your opinion would be more valid if I clicked on your profile, like you say, this is what you got to do. I click on it and you're this Adonis. You're beautifully sculpted. Perfect skin. Everything, but you never are. So I will only listen to your definites, so much. Come on. Think about what you're saying. They fail to realize we need to be attacking Buckby. Somebody says the only Greek that Constantine knows. Frank, yes. Great. All right, we got to tell you what Buckby said. Now, first, I've got some other stuff here. I want to read you this email that I got about the Prouds. This is pretty concerning, but it goes back to what I said. So listen to this. Email about the Prouds. This came in just before the show. They're still with the creatine stuff. Is this some kind of gag now? Somebody says, Mike, you're going to need to buy a cloak to hide that Steven Crowder physique if you don't settle down on the creatine. I'd ditch it altogether if I were you. Again, I'm taking 2,500 grams. That is the low dose pre-workout. That is not too much. On my first health kick, I did creatine every day. It didn't do anything bad for me. Come on. Stop it with what you think you know about creatine. This will all be fine. Okay? I seen Gavin do 18 push-ups. Yes, I could do many more push-ups than Gavin. I could do about 50 in a row where Gavin fails at about 20, and he doesn't even do them that good. Oh, yeah, we wanted to see Gavin in a cloak. Here we go. Okay, let's do Gavin in a cloak. Then I'm going to read you this really scary email I got from the Proud Boys. Then I'm going to read you the Buckby message, and then we'll wrap up because we only got 10 minutes left. Okay? We got after shows coming up at redbarradio.net right after this. And as far as the working out thing, be encouraging. Be helpful. Don't be so negative. I see this with everyone with Newt. It's like you want to be negative and go, oh, you're doing it all wrong. You know, it's an ongoing joke about people going to the gym, and there's always a guy going, you ain't doing it right. You're not doing that right. Wasn't that some bit? What was that from? But it's an ongoing gag that whenever you try to better yourself, there's a guy who comes out and says, you ain't doing it right. Those people, there's a problem with you. I don't know what it is yet. I'll investigate. But it should be encouragement. It should be sharing information that worked. But it shouldn't be, that's wrong, that's wrong, that's wrong, that's wrong. Okay? Mike, don't eat garbage and travel abroad. Stop. It's insulting. Okay, let's watch Gavin in a cloak. Here we go. This is his new image. The cloak is old news. He put it on months ago. No, no, no. Not to us. What are you, a real Proud Boy? This guy's name is Constantine PB. I think he's a real Proud Boy. To us, this is an old news. Let's see this cloak. Check one, two. Cloak, look at this cloak. Oh, I didn't even see this. It's got a skull on the back, and it's a gown. It looks like a graduation gown that you would wear. Look at that. That, oh my God. So yeah, it looks like a graduation gown, and he wears it over his Fred Perry Proud Boys polo, and he leaves the polo collar, the yellow stripes, out of the cloak. I mean, this, it's not even a joke. See, people are saying the cloak is brand new to me. Yeah, it's like, yeah, maybe he wore the cloak once to a Proud Boys meetup. Sorry, we weren't there. Look at this cloak.
Bonjour, États-Unis. Je m'appelle Gavin Desbois.
I wish I had the nerve to wear costumes. I mean, I don't know, though. I don't know. Is it complete confidence to, hey, I'm wearing a funny costume? Or is it, I want attention and look what I'm trying. Look at all these attempts. I still can't get over that. I have this thing where I get embarrassed. I can't do things that these other people do. Like, again, I was watching reality shows and I go, I could never do what these people do. It'd be so embarrassing. Don't people get embarrassed? And like with Gavin, he always is wearing a costume. And I always wonder, is it confidence or nerve? You know, do I not have the nerve to wear something like this? Or do I not have the confidence to wear something like this? Either way, to me, I could never imagine coming on in these costumes. For what?
And I'm wearing a robe I got at an antique store. It's for the Oddfellows.
I'm wearing a robe I got at the antique store. It's for the Oddfellows. I don't know what that is. And then we're going to tune in tomorrow's episode real quick, where he goes, am I wearing the same cloak?
Back when everyone had a lodge. Back before fucking feminist cunts ruined men's clubs. We have a Proud Boy meeting tonight. We're going to go to Times Square, meet at the police station there, and have a vigil. For
Okay. This isn't a joke, guys. I know. I hate that people are like, he's doing a bit. These are not bits. Trust me. All right, now let's go to his next show. Because he's wearing the cloak again. So I think it was on the last show. Yeah, here we go. So look at this. These aren't bits. Okay? That would be great if they were. So here's the next show. Cloaks coming out your stereo. This one's coming out your stereo. We was always meant to be some. Born to a fighter on the deep south side.
What does it say here?
Hello. Welcome to Casual Friday Thursdays here on the Gavin McInnes Show. Had a Proud Boys meet
now,
up last night.
Now, this isn't the cloak. This is a suit.
Shit hammered.
But he says something like, am I wearing the same cloak as yesterday?
Listen. Fucking rode my bicycle home from the train station in the pouring rain wearing my big Proud Boys cloak that I wear, the one I wore on yesterday's show. Wait, was I wearing this shirt on yesterday's show?
Oh, okay. That's
That's not a good look. That doesn't look good when you scroll through the different shows.
Okay, so this is all I wanted to play was... He was talking about his clothes. I was always meant to be some. Born to a fighter on the deep south
side. A sweaty little girl, what you do? Hello. Welcome to Casual Friday Thursdays here on the Gavin McInnes Show. Had a Proud Boys meet up last night. I'm feeling pretty shit hammered. I fucking rode my bicycle home from the train station in the pouring rain wearing my big Proud Boys cloak that I wear, the one I wore.
I find that so funny. I was wearing my big Proud Boys cloak that I wear.
Ah, why are you wearing a cloak?
All right, that's enough of cloak talk. I promised you the Buckbee message, so we're going to end with that, but we're going to be coming back at redbarradio.tv with an after show here today. Okay, so you're all welcome to join us right after the show at redbarradio.tv. All right. And I want to get this in because I promised you I would. So here it is, the message I got from Jack Buckbee, and this is a world record. None of our fools have ever tried this before. And we're going to see. We're going to come up with an answer today. I haven't decided yet because I'd like to be thoughtful. You know, this is a big decision. Jack Buckbee himself, this is not fake.
I would really appreciate it if you and your people would lay off me and Martina. I trust you are a man of your word. I'm told you have said that if I were to ask you to end this, you would. I'm just trying to live my life. I don't particularly care what you think of me. But the constant Twitter harassment is just unpleasant and unnecessary, especially when directed towards my fiancé. I'm not interested in any kind of stupid online war with you, your cartoonist friend, or your followers. I would have thought that was clear from the beginning. I don't want anything to do with you, and I would appreciate it if you would respect that. Jack Buckbee.
Ladies and gentlemen of the bar. It's never before been done. And I've always said, all you got to do is ask, and we won't bother you. Remember? Haven't I always said that about every one of our fools? We're not harassers. We like to have some fun. But we're not mean people, and we're not trying to hurt people. Jack Buckbee has reached out to me after 11 weeks of being made fun of to the day. This came in right before the show today. It's been 11 weeks since we joined Compound Media, and I believe it was on the after show of the very first episode we got into the Buckbee stuff after he said that shit he said about me. And here we are after 11 weeks. He has asked if I would stop. Now, before I honor his request, if I do at all, I'd like to let everybody know that this is a complete and utter admission of defeat. We kicked his ass. We have officially won. If there is winning involved at all, that's what's happened. Buckbee has come crawling. This could easily be fake. It's not fake. It's him. Nobody hacked him. It's real. He's asked the same thing to Sven Stuffles. So here we go. What do we do? Because this has never been done before. And I always said, we are not here to attack people. We are not here to bother people. And if they simply just said, listen, man. But for 11 weeks, his ego got in the way. And then he realized when he quit Proud Boys and all this stuff, he doesn't want this. And that's what all the fools don't want. So I'm going to think about it. This is another win for Redbar. That needs to be perfectly clear. And I kind of need a few people to say, you were right about Buck B. You weren't just talking out of your ass. You didn't do this for publicity. You didn't do this for this. Have a little respect for what we do here on the show. And just say, you were right about Buck B. You know, the thing that Proud Boys private messaged to me day in and day out. But don't hold on to the ego. Don't hold on to the pride, you Proud Boys. Just admit, you stunk. So Jack Buckby, I will think about this. What could sweeten that up for me and get me to come to a conclusion sooner? Maybe an apology. How about this, Jack? Offer me an apology. Say, you know what? I got a lot of stuff going on. Maybe I do need to be a little bit better. Maybe I am a fool. I apologize. And then bow. A full bow. Not a half bow. Not a shit bow. But a full 90 degree bow. And we'll think about it. But you, what you have witnessed here is a man who is not as tough and as proud as he says he is. People that weren't ready to come on the internet and talk all this shit. All it took was a couple making fun ofs to get these people to beg to stop. Jack, I am a man of my word for the most part. 70% of the time, I'm a man of my word. And you know what? I will consider this over the weekend, and we will let you know next Friday. Now, let's say I did decide to stop. It's going to be tough. For one, because if you and Martina keep putting out nonsense content, it's very hard to look away. So you got to try, too. You got to try to stop putting out nonsense. The other thing, too, I'm going to retaliate anytime I hear a word about me. So that means you got to be completely silent about me. So we'll see. I'm going to give this some serious thought. Because I don't, you know, these people aren't my enemies. These people are just fools that I wanted to make fun of. I'm not trying to demolish them or hurt them, like I've said many times. So when you hear a man say, I don't want to be made fun of, then to make fun of him after that is cruelty. And we are not cruel. We're cool. I'll think about it, Jack. You little, tiny guy. Jack Buckby, everybody. 11 weeks, and we saw his true colors. Thank you guys so much for listening to Red Bar. We'll be right back after this with some after show. Consider joining the Barmy. This show is ad-free. We'll be right back with more after show at redbarradio.tv. Hope you had a good time. Shout out!
Come on, big fella, you drunk, big fella. 2 cents and now you want to trip, big fella. You not a drinker. I can see it all in your leg, big fella. You wobbly, big fella. You finna fall. Sit down, you drunk, big fella.
All night up the chicken, all night up the chicken, all night up the chicken. Hey, hey.
Everybody outside, everybody outside, wanna pull up outside all night though. Everybody high five, everybody wanna smile, everybody wanna lie, that's nice though. Oh, now you wanna chill, oh, now you wanna build, oh, now you got to build, that's cool.
We'll be right back, RedbarRadio.tv.
Oh, now you wanna laugh, oh, now you need a cab, that's true though.
All you do is talk, I ain't got shit to say. Can't no one get in my car, I don't even valet.
Long discussions, oh, you my cousin? No, you wasn't. You just want to ride. You just want to talk about politics, Chicago shit, and rock shit. Start dancing, ho.